Anthony Fasano from the Engineering Management Institute, and I'm here at the offices of Pennoni with Joe Viscuso. And we did a full podcast episode, but in this Engineering Manager 80-20 short, Joe, I just have one question for you. You've been doing engineering for a long time. You've had a long career, very successful. And I've spoken to you several times. We've done some stuff together. And you always seem to have a tremendous amount of energy. You know, you like dealing with people. You're very energetic. And I speak to a lot of people, and sometimes you're much more energetic than people that are maybe just starting their career, and you seem excited and passionate. What is it that drives you on a daily basis that keeps you going at such a high energy level, such high momentum?
That's a great question, and I get it a lot, right? But because I get the fact that people say, where do you get all the energy that you have? I travel a lot. And traveling schedules are never easy, right? You know, early flights, red eyes back from California, you know, whatever. But I think you're driven by the passion and the love for what you do, right? I don't think that if I were doing something I didn't really enjoy, I don't think I would have the energy. So I think the fact that I love, as an engineer, you get to see your results. You design something and then you get to see it and you get to drive past it and you get to go to it. Or sit in it, or participate.
Keeps
in
you
it.
Going.
So it's loving what you do, I think that engineering is a big field, and there's a lot of things that you can do in the engineering space.
Right.
So if you're not passionate about what you do, and you are, you know, you have that, and engineers are trained differently. We think differently. Sometimes that's good. Sometimes that's bad.
Right.
But
sure.
Because it's such a big space and a big field, you should be able to find some place that really I love to grow things.
Yeah.
That's what I love to do. Right. So to me, I'm a top line kind of person. And growing a firm, growing growing a new element of the firm,
sure.
A new business
that
line.
That excites you.
That excites
Energizes
me, right?
You.
Because again, I get to see the results. But I've done, worked on thousands of projects, and I can ride around and see those projects, and I know where they are, and I know what went right and what went wrong.
Yeah.
And you learn from those. But again, I think the fact that I love what I do is where I get the energy.
Where you get the energy, yeah. And one thing that I'll just say, kind of to piggyback on that there, is the world of civil engineering, the world of engineering is such a big industry. And so to Joe's point, you may be trained in one specific discipline, but maybe you're not that passionate about it. Maybe you're not that energized by it. Do something else in the industry. I mean, Joe and I recorded a whole podcast on smart cities, which we'll link to. Maybe you want to become an expert in a new technology and innovate into something else using your education as a base and building off of it. I think that's one thing that I talk to a lot of younger engineers. And they feel like, well, I went down this road and I'm not that happy. Well, change.
Right.
Right? In today's world, you can innovate. I mean, there's new technologies that people haven't had any training on at all.
Right.
Like we talked about a little bit in the episode, there's companies that have been built around a new network like 5G that are going to be built that don't exist.
Don't even exist.
So the same thing can happen in your career. If you're an engineer with some kind of training, you're not locked into that degree or whatever you had a major in or a minor in, you can flex. And to get to the point where Joe is, where you find that little niche that brings you a lot of joy, that can bring you energy and that can ultimately bring you success.
Yeah, I mean, I like to design? I love to design things. I don't, because of where I am in my career, I'm not sitting at a computer designing things today, but I'm lending my expertise to a lot of projects that I have experience in and directing some of our PMs that may have not seen this kind of project before, our junior people, you know, whatever the case may be. But again, I found my motivation from the sales side of growing things and growth. So do I still like projects? Yes, but I'm, if I were having to sit and design things every year, probably wouldn't have been as passionate I wouldn't have the energy that I do. But because I can see the results of kind of what I do and where I can go and getting into new space all the time is really a motivator for me.
That's great. All right, Joe Viscuso, Pennoni. Joe, thanks again for doing this.
We really appreciate it.
We're going to link to our longer podcast episodes so you can learn about smart cities, and be sure to subscribe to our channel here to get our weekly videos. Thank you.